بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهداه أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته today I want to talk about a sentence that this guy bro Hajji brought against the دعوة النجدية أو محمد بن عبد الوهاب. And he brought also like a short clip from Abdurrahman Hassan about problems manhajiyya from ISIS. Huh? What is the thing that he brought? He said, like, he brought the thing to say, this is why Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab or the Da'wah al-Najdiyah ككل is a problem and is the door to extremism. وهذا ضلال مبين. This guy is ignorant and he's stupid. والله العظيم. Why I say he's stupid? Because if someone say something like this, you know that he never read a book of the Salaf about their aqidah. He never read a book from the Salaf. And he can say, I read and I did and I did. If he did, then he would never say something like this. Huh? But he didn't. He didn't. طيب? Why do I say something like this? Because I will show you that the Salaf, they had such a thing. What is this thing? What is this qaida? The qaida is that, like Bro Hajji is saying, the thing that makes Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab extreme or a door to extremism is that he is saying everyone who contradicts our manhaj is of dalal, is in dalal. Or, yeah, he is not on the haq. طيب? And then he said, look, and this manhaj that Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab has, it's the same that ISIS have now. And so he made this conclusion. He said, look, because this and that, because this, they have that. Because this, ISIS have this this manhaj. Huh? وهذا ضلال مبين. هذا ضلال مبين. And like I said in the first video against this guy, that he make a conclusion about with Muhammad ibn Wahab and ISIS, so the people, they see this thing really big, because today the people are like this. Allah musta'an. So what is the point of the Sunni or a Muslim Sunni in this topic? What is the manhaj of a Sunni in this topic? We have Imam al-Barbahari rahmatullahi alayhi, he said in his sharh sunnah, وَلَا يَحِلُّ لِرَجُلٍ مُسْلِمٍ أَن يَقُولَ فُلَانٌ صَاحِبُ سُنَّةٍ حَتَّى يَعْلَمَ مِنْهُ أَنَّهُ قَدْ اجْتَمَعَتْ فِيهِ خِصَالُ السُنَّةِ. Yeah, al-Barbahari and the A'imma said he is the Imam al-Hanabila in his time. He was not someone like today. Al-Barbahari is like a football. Everyone who comes, he can kick. Huh? And Bro Hajji, he himself, he made fun about Al-Barbahari and said it's the Talmud of the Madakhil and so on. And he will stay in front of Al-Barbahari yawm al-Qiyamah. Huh? And Al-Barbahari will take his haqq. He don't need you. He don't need the kalam of Bro Hajji to, he don't need Bro Hajji to say Sul Sunnah is like such a great book. He don't need your comment. Huh? He don't need you. But this thing you said, you will be judged by that. And Al-Barbahari will take his haqq. Huh? From all the people, also from Muhammad Hijab and so on. So he said in his Sharh Sunnah, that it's not allowed for a Muslim to say Fulan is Sunni until the Khisal Sunnah until the opinions of the Sunnah and the different topics is in him. Until the Sunnah is in him, all the Sunnah. Huh? We say this in Sunnah, but we don't say this in Islam. We say someone come to Islam, one is Muslim, when he says Shahada, then he comes in. Then he needs to pray and to fast and so on. But he don't need to do all this to be a Muslim. He needs the Shahada first, and then the other things. But to say someone who is he's a Sunni, he needs just things. Huh? And if he don't know, there's something else. But when he knows, and he has to learn these things, then he has to be on the opinion of the Salaf al-Salih. Tayyib, Barbahari now, is he a Hujja? You can say no. You can say no. We want someone else. We want Quran and Sunnah. And so on. Tayyib, the Hadith al-Iftiraq. Hadith al-Iftiraq. Not Hadith al-Iftiraq. Hadith... ما يعيش منكم بعدي whoever after me whoever lives after me فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا he will see a lot of اختلاف فعليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين you have to be on the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in these things والخلفاء الراشدين المهديين and I said I had a video clip or audio about taking the path of the Salaf. So we have all these matters of the Sunnah from the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ or from the Khulafa al-Rashidin or from the people of the Salaf who were praised in the Quran. Yeah? And who wants to know where the Salaf, التابعين مثلا, were praised in the Quran, go back to the audio inshaAllah ta'ala. So it's just Barbahari who said this? No. Also Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Imam Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'a, he said this in his book Usul al-Sunnah. And also Abu Nasir al-Sijzi in his book Ar-Rad ala man ankara al-harfa wal-sawt. And also Al-Sabuni in his book Al-I'tiqad ashab al-Hadith. And also Harb ibn Ismail al-Kirmani. A lot of people who don't know this guy, know these scholars, don't know these scholars, will not know these scholars. But Harb ibn Ismail is Imam, is a Imam. He was a student of Imam Ahmed and Ishaq ibn Rahaway. Imam Ahmed said about Ishaq ibn Rahaway, he's a Imam, he's an Imam. And you see the opinions of Ishaq a lot in the Kutub. A lot, his كتب الحنابلة مثلا القديمة, in the old books you see a lot the opinions of Ishaq ibn Rahaway, and he was Imam بلا شك. So all this we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and al Barbahari who said this, and we have the تعامل of the Salaf ككل, we have the تعامل, when they said إيمان يزيد وينقص, إيمان goes up and down, what did they say when someone don't say this? He said, you are mubtadi', you are a murji'i. You are a murji'i. Who don't do istithna' in iman. Who don't say, I'm Muslim, insha'Allah. They said, you are a murji'i. Who said, al-iman is in the qalb, is in the heart. You don't have to spell it with your tongue to be a Muslim. They said, you are a jahmi. So everyone who contradicted the opinion of the Salaf was a Mubtadi' or a Kafir. Just these two things. So they said, they also said, who's not on our manhaj, he's imma, a Mubtadi' or a Kafir. It depends on the topic, on how big is his problem, and why does he say something. This is really important to know. That it is not something that Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab brought. Yeah? Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, like, look, we have a video from Salih Fawzan. He said, give me one person that Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, or one Muslim, he said, give me one Muslim Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab made takfir on. Because he said, oh, the people who are against this da'wah, They are zanadiqa or mubtadi'a. Like, to be honest. Yeah? They are imma mubtadi'a. They have problems. They are deviant or they are mushrikeen. Not because they are against the da'wah. Because you see that the people who are against the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Wahab, they have certain sifat. They have certain sifat. It's not just like I wake up and I say I'm against the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Wahab. No. Why are you against the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab? Because this and this and this and this. Tayyib, these things, are they a bid'ah? Are they shirk? Are they sunnah? Are they haram? And so on. And if you look to the people who are against Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, they're extreme Sufis. Or they're Sufis. They are not Salafis at all. If you say like Muhammad, and then you know you can say like, oh, how you make this thing so big and so on. Look at the people who are against Muhammad ibn Wahab. Why they are against? And what sifat do they have? Huh? So Salaf Fawzan said, give me one Muslim he made takfir on. He don't made takfir on Muslim. He said kafir to a person that worshipped a grave. And also Salaf Fawzan said, give me one Muslim that Muhammad ibn Wahab killed that was a Muslim. He didn't kill Muslimin. Huh? When there was a jihad and so on, he made jihad against the mushrikeen, the people that worship graves, extreme Sufis and so on. That was the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Nothing else. And it was, this da'wah was mabniya ala al-Qur'ani wa sunnah wa aqwal salaf hadhihi al-ummah. This was his da'wah. He didn't put out something from his head. Yeah. So just to summarize this thing, topic. The problem that this guy Bro Hajji has is that he think that everyone who's saying whoever contradicts my manhaj is not upon the haq, it's a problem. This sentence is a problem. No, it's not a problem. This is sunnah. This is the sunnah. Then we have the topics about al-iman, about our opinion about the sahaba, masalat al-Quran, and so on, al-qadr, and so on. So we have, in these topics, we have an opinion. Whoever contradicts this opinion, or who's not on this opinion, he's imma in bid'ah, or kufr, or shirk. Huh? Yes? Go back to the early books of the Salaf. You will see tabdi' or takfir. Huh? So this is very, very important. So, because a lot of people, they listen to this guy, and they don't listen to others. And then he says, like, they say, you opened my eyes, and you did this, and you do that. No, this guy, he never read something. And I really think that he's just the face. So we have behind him, Sufis and so on, who give them all these things, stupid things, and then he can talk. Just to know, Abu Hamid al-Isfarayni, he was a mujaddid of the Shafi'iyya. The Shafi'iyya says he was a mujaddid. Mujaddid al-Shafi'iyya. What did he say? He say, people who say like, I'm upon an opinion and the other is upon his opinion and the other is upon his opinion. In Aqidah. This is no problem. And like today they say like Ash'ari, it's no problem, he's also from Ahl Sunnah. Maturidi, no problem. This guy, ma fi ishkal. Qadari, ma fi ishkal. All from Ahl Sunnah. It's all like we are all on the same path. Every path goes back to Quran, Sunnah, and so on. This garbage. He says, yani about this is called takaful adilla. He said about this thing, takafu al-adilla, that there is no haqq. everyone who believes something, in his opinion, this is haq. طيب this is haq. It called takaful adilla. He said awwaluhu safsata wa akhiruhu zandaqa. Awwaluhu safsata, I don't know the word of in English safsata. It's like garbage, yeah? Stupid mind map. Stupid mind. Like, I don't know, afwan. Safsata. You can look, go back and look. Huh? Like it's false and it's stupid. In fiqh, he said, if someone said this in fiqh, this is a problem. But in aqidah, it is zandaqa. It's zandaqa. That we say, no problem. Huh? What does this guy say? It's like, طيب, if Muhammad ibn Wahab said, everyone is not the one, on my opinion, he's on batil, this sentence is extremism. طيب, what do you say? Everyone who believes whatever he wants, he's on haq. Then this is zandaqa, if you say this. So what is your opinion? طيب, he always say just like, look at Muhammad ibn Wahab, what he say, look at this, what he say, look at that, look at this. طيب, give us your aqidah. Give us your aqidah. What is your belief? You just point fingers. Tell us. We want to know from you what's the haq. Yalla. Give us. You just say, oh, look this, look this. Give us your aqidah so that we know what you believe. Subhanallah al-Azim. This guy is ajib jiddan. Wallahu alam. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.